Hi, Linda Kay here from lindakaystampandpage.blogspot.com with my August 20th, 2021 video to the collab I'm in titled Fab 4 Collab. This collab is hosted by Paige, who is Stamp Girl here on YouTube, as well as Deb Hauk. The purpose of this collab is for us to pull out one of the fabulous four crafting tools, and now that could be a die, a stencil, an embossing folder, or a punch, and create a project and share that project with you here on YouTube on the 20th of every month. I'm going to go over the products that I used, and I'll show you the project that I created. I pulled out of my stash this old retired Stampin' Up! Angled Tag Topper punch, and I also pulled out an embossing folder, but it's not any embossing folder. This is the Icon Cut and Emboss Folders by Anna Griffin. It came two folders per package, and I used a little cross right there. Now, I've never really used cut and emboss folders, and for these embellishments, they turned out adorable, just adorable. And I would highly recommend anybody to get those again. Here is the folder itself, and I only use the cross right there. And I probably cut about 30 of them out, and the folder's no worse for wear. So I'm gonna use these more often. So those are two of the fabulous four products or tools that I used for my craft room. Another one that we don't have on the list, but I have it in my craft room. I use my Cricut Air Explorer. I don't use it enough, and I used it for this month's project, and it turned out nice. Well, in addition to those tools, I also use basic white cardstock by Stampin' Up. I used the Forever Fern stamp set, and I used these little images here as well as the little scatter spots. Inks, I used Shaded Spruce, Pretty Peacock, Pear Pizzazz. Embellishments, I used the basic linen thread by Stampin' Up, and I winked the crosses with my clear Wink of Stella. I'm going to show you the inspiration. But first, I don't know if most of you know this, but I have a great nephew, and great he is. He's stolen my heart, that little Wally. He's the sweetest little boy. But his mommy came to me a few months ago and asked me if I could help create tags for his baptism. And I said, of course. So she showed me what she purchased off of Etsy. And I took her file and I printed it. And this is part of the tag. And I was a little disappointed in how muted it was. The image wasn't that crisp. And I thought, you know what? I think I could do a little bit better. So I pulled out my Cricut and I went into Design Space and I typed in the message or the thank you that Dory wanted the back to read. And here are the tags right here. And I'll show you how the Cricut cut it, or it didn't cut it, it printed it. I used it to write the thank you. So it says, thank you for joining us to celebrate the baptism of our son, and it has Wally's name and the date. So then after I had it cut or printed on basic white cardstock, I cut it all down by 2x3 and used the angled tag topper punch for the top. And then on plain basic white, I cut the same number of plain tags, and then I just stamped the images and the scatter dots. And then here is a close-up of that little heart, or excuse me, that little cross that was cut and embossed with that folder by Anna Griffin. Now, what I did here is I didn't think I could get the Cricut to write that small, and then I thought, well, how am I going to put that little image on in the Cricut. So I thought, you know what? They have clear address labels. So I went to Staples and I purchased these clear mailing labels, and I just went on the computer and typed in this little sentiment here: faith plants the seed, love makes it grow. And then I printed the labels, one sheet. I cut them down a little bit so that they weren't as long as the address label, and I stuck it on there and burnished it. And you can't even tell. So these are my tags, and I made 25 of these beautiful tags. And what Dory's plan is she's going to be giving little succulents or cactus in like little ceramic pots. And then I told her we can just take a rubber band and put it around the pot, and then slide this back tag behind the rubber band and just kind of angle it like this. And you wouldn't even see the rubber band because it would be up here. And then that way, when she's at the church, she doesn't have to bother with untying and tying all these little bows again. So I think that Dory's going to be very happy, and that I improved on this Etsy shop purchase of hers. What do you think? Leave me a comment below and tell me what you think, how that looks. I think mine looks a lot nicer. So these are my 25 tags, and I am going to leave a link below to both Deb and Paige's channel, as well as all the other participants. And I encourage you to head over to their channels and see what fabulous tools they pulled out of their craft room and what wonderful projects they've created. And I want to thank you for watching. And as always, please like, comment, and subscribe. And if you hit that little notification button down there, you are assured of never missing another one of these marvelous videos. Well, catch you next month. Bye.